Good Morning Church. We're going to be looking at the second kind of church there is in the world. First kind of church is the church that's doing well and doing good works and having some impact upon its community, being very faithful in some aspects, but has lost its first love. It's becoming more of a legalistic church, a loveless church. But then also, now we're going to look at the Smyrna church, beginning in verse number 8 of chapter 2. And he says, "To the angel of the church of Smyrna write, these things says the first, the last, who was dead and came to life." And he represents himself as the one who died and came to life because this church was being heavily persecuted. This is the persecuted church. This is the loyal church. It's not the loveless church. In fact, this church is so loyal that it's willing to die for the things it believes in. Verse 9, he says, "I know your works and tribulation and poverty, that you are rich. And I know that, but you are rich. But I know the blasphemy of those who say that they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan." Now, Smyrna was a city where they were very zealous for their devotion to the gods, the Greek gods. There was a city of Jews there, or a community of Jews there also, who hated the Christians, were persecuting the Christians. But most of the persecution we know historically came from the people who were fanatically convinced that the Roman gods were true gods, and they were zealous for Rome and all that she had, and even emperor worship. And so when the Christians wouldn't bow down and worship Caesar, or acknowledge at least that Caesar was Lord, then they were heavily persecuted. And so this is the persecuted church. But it was loyal to Christ. Even in the midst of persecution, they did exactly what God wanted them to do in their community. And they became a lighthouse to their community, even though they were heavily oppressed. They were very poor, and they couldn't even hold jobs oftentimes. But they continued to be faithful, even unto death. He says in verse 10 at the very end, "Be faithful until death, and I will give you the crown of life." There are many churches in our world today that are being persecuted, even beyond what we're reading about in Smyrna. There are churches who have to even go into hiding. And if people find out that they are Christian, then their houses are burned, or they themselves are put in prison, oftentimes even put unto death. And so we have sister churches like this all over the world. Thank the Lord that we don't have that yet in America, but I do believe that's coming for us very soon. Now, why would God allow persecution? Why does God allow persecution? Number one, it purifies the church. I believe what's happening right now in America is the church is being purified. Those who have very little commitment, we're going to be seeing falling away. We're probably in the midst of the great falling away that Paul talked about. There would be a great falling away before the coming of the Lord. And there are many people going away from the church and many for very many reasons and so forth. But when persecution finally comes, when it's going to actually cost you to go to church, you can promise that most of them will abandon the church. Also, to try and test the church, to show the church, you know, where it's at, to see if it's strong. Then to strengthen the church. Oftentimes, persecution strengthens the church. In fact, the early church was persecuted in Jerusalem, and all it did was fan the flames of revival. All it did was drive them out into the world to evangelize the world. And so it can strengthen the church as well. Sometimes it's to give believers opportunity to glorify God. God allows persecution and problems and situations, cancers, difficulties in our lives, because it gives us an opportunity to glorify God in the midst of our trials and tribulations. And then sometimes it's just for God's sovereign purpose. We don't know why. Job's situation was for God's sovereign purpose. It was to allow Satan to see that there was a man on the earth who loved God above all else. And so God has sovereign purposes. But he does allow persecution, but it's always got a reason behind it. God never just lets something happen just because he's careless. It's always got a purpose. If a Christian is suffering, there is a purpose behind it. And we just need to hold on, be faithful, and continue to let God do his redeeming work in us. Let us pray together. Father, I pray for our sister churches around the world. We don't know how good we have it here, because we can do what we need to do and not have to fear the authorities or fear our neighbors. But Father, in those countries, they are going through some very difficult times, particularly in Muslim countries where Christ is not allowed to be preached. And so, Father, I pray that you would protect them and watch over them, and may their fruit be in abundance in those nations. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.